Hello guys, today we are going to discussing about how to create LVMs in Linux. So I am using Red Hat 7. On that I am creating a LVM. How to create the LVM? First we need to check the our physical disk. So how many disk has connected physically to the our server? So first we have to enter the command fdisk-l. Here it will be show. As of now, my server, it has connected two disks, /dev/sda and /dev/sdb. These are the two disks has connected. So first we have to create a one partition on. So I am using for LVM disk 2. This is the operating system which is created, already installed. The /dev/sda disk is completely from operating system. I am using the operating system installed on that, and this is the data disk. Now I am going to creating as a LVM on this disk. Okay, so first we have to enter the disk /dev/sdb. I am going to use a second disk. Okay, yeah, first we have to check the m for help command. So here some option is showing, pop-up has here. So here we have to choose n for creative. Now we are going to creating a new partition, then we have to create the new partition. N for create a new partition. Here is showing our partition table. Partition table, there will be option, four options on that. Meanwhile we can create a three primary partitions. Minimum we can create as a three primary partitions. We can create maximum four primary partitions. Why we are not creating four primary partitions? In the sense, if your so our complete disk size is 20 GB. On the 20 GB, first 5 GB I was created one primary, second 5 GB also created one primary, third 5 GB also I was created one primary. So remaining 5 GB is left. So on that 5 GB I was created one more primary with the 2 GB. So what about remaining 3 GB space? So we have wasted that space. So that's why we have to create that one, three primary, remaining one is we have to create as a extend partition. On that extend partition we have to create a number of logical partitions. So now we are going to creating, this is the first partitions. Here is showing primary partitions has 0, extended partition has 0. So complete our partition table, all four as free. Okay, now if you enter the p, then enter. If you choose the number you can choose, then it will be take as a default one. Okay, 4, enter. So first sector always we have to press enter. Second last sector we have to give the 5 GB space. Okay, yeah, sorry, 5 MB. Okay, plus 5 GB, enter. Okay, P for print. So we are created one partition here. Okay, so and we'll save and exist. After save and exist, after that we have to sync the partition, which partition we are created, that partition we need to sync to disk. So we have to enter the command partpro/dev/sdb, done. Okay, we are syncing completely the disk. So on the disks, so many partitions, if you have created so many partitions, there is no issue. If you are sync the disk, if you have to sync the partition, there is no issue. There will be update with partition table. Now we have to convert which we are created the partition. That partition we need to convert to pv. Okay, pv create /dev/sdb1. Okay, successfully we are created pv. Okay, as of now, first we are created one partition only, and that partition we are converted to pv. next step is we have to create volume group. So why we are choosing volume group, in the sense, number of pvs we are, so every day in future, in real time, so data will be going to reaching as a 90%. At the time we are connecting the physical disk. Okay, one more physical disk we are connecting to the server. That every physical disk we need to convert to pv first. After pv we have to add to volume group. So we have number of pvs we are adding as a one volume group. On that volume group to we are creating a number of logical volume groups. So this volume group, in the sense, it will work as a bunch of data. So bunch of space, so number of pvs, like how many pvs you are added, it's your choice, but those number of PVs we have to convert as a volume group. That volume group that volume group we need to use to create a number of logical partitions. So we are creating one PV, and we'll do one more thing. We have to create one more disk, okay, one more partition SDB, and that I'm going to creating one more partition, and primary 2 and default 1 and first sector, last sector I have to give more 5 GB, enter, and I have to create one more partition primary, and I have to create enter third and first sector, and second sector, last sector I have to give plus 5 GB. Okay, so as of now I was created 3 primary partitions. Okay, we'll go for create one more extended, no issue here, only we'll go for one more partition, new for create a partition, and E for extend, and first sector, last sector always we have to enter. Okay, and P for print, extend also is done. Okay, now that extend we have to create one logical partition, N first sector, always it will take automatically fifth partition. When we are going to creating the first logical partition, it will take as a adding fifth, which number it will start with 5. Okay, first sector, on that first sector we will take 2 GB. okay, and P. So as of now we are created 3 primary partitions, one is logical partition, done, save and exist. We have to sync to partition table slash dev SDB, done. So first partition which we are created, that part partition already we are converted to PV. Just we have to check the command, how many PVs has created. So only one PV has created, showing that size and everything here showing. If you want to check more details, just you have to PV display. Okay, here it will be show PV name, and if in the PV we are using the LVM, if you are, as of now we are not added to LVM, so here is not showing nothing, and there is a PV size and everything. Now we can add to more PVs, PV create, okay, and slash dev, yes, slash dev slash SDB, SDB 2, SDB 3 and SDB 5. So one more partition we are created for extended partition. On that extended partition we can't form it, and you can't use for data copying or data removing on that partition. Just that extended partition we need to use to convert enter to way to LVM. So we can't use that extended partition. Okay, so how many PVs we are created as of now? PVs. So as of now we are created 4 PVs. And that 4 PVs, 3 primary partitions, 3 primary standard partition, one is a logical partition. So here I am including that how to create a standard partition, that one also, and that I was created as a 4 partitions. Okay, so after creating 4 partition we have to create 2 volume group. Okay, VG create, yeah, we have to enter the volume group name VG0, VG1. Okay, and we have to give to slash dev slash SDB1, done. One PV is added to one LVM. Okay, just we have to press PVS. Now first one is added here. Here it's showing VG, there is no VGs here, but here we are added one VG1, here is showing, right. Okay, we have to add remaining also 2 and 3 and 5. It's done, already exist. Okay, already exist. PV5 is added. Okay, PVS. We'll see as of now how many, 1, 2, 3. But here is showing, one second, VG1, VG created. So we have to VG extend. VG. So already VG has created, that's why it's not creating. VG extend, then slash dev slash SD B 2 and VG 1. Okay, it's not taking like this. VG 1 slash dev SD B 2. Yeah, it's extended. 3 and 5. So now we'll see PVS. It's done. before that is actually we are wrong, we have made some mistakes here. So I was manually adding that command vg create. Once we'll create the vg, so already vg has created through using this disk. If you want to add so many disks here, there is no issue, but here added only one disk on that disk. So after that we are extended the eg volume group. So remaining disk, what are the disk is there, we are added on that. If you want to add as a single command, there is no issue with that. You can use for all disk, what are the PBC is there, we have to add as a single time, there is no issue. So as of now VG S, so our VG has created. And how many PBC here, what is the VG name? VG0, VG1, and what is the PBs, how many PBs we are added? 4 PBs. How many LVMs we are created using this VG? There is no LVM 0 and SN ultras and VG size and free size. So completely 15.82 GB and 15.82 GB is completely free. As of now we are not created any volume groups using this VG. Okay, now we are going to create one volume group. Okay, LV create, we have to use the command LV create. Before that VG display, we have to use VG display. If you enter VGS in the same, it will short formation, will get the information about the VG. If you enter the VG display, so see, and VG name, system ID, and formatted, which formatted, LVM always it will use to LVM to format only, and metadata areas and metadata screens numbers and accessory, what are the permissions as there, and what is the VG size, PB size, and what is the PB total PBs on that. Okay, so block size, okay, PB block size also here is showing. Okay, now we are going to create a LV create. Before that we have to give the size plus, okay, 5 GB. On that we have to use hyphen n for name. What is the LVM name? LV1 using for VG1. Got it? Here LV create, then hyphen capital L, in the sense what is the size of our LVM, using which LVM volume group we are going to creating, n for name. So our giving now we are giving the LVM name LV1, and what is from where onwards we are creating this LVM. So using this volume group we are creating the one LVM with 5 GB. Okay, enter. See, logical volume LV1 was created, it's fine. So we'll have to check, LVS, we have to use the sat formation command, LV1, VG1, and what is the size of that. Okay, we have to use full form, full LV, LV display. Okay, so here it will be get the path also, our LVM path also. Okay, LV1/devsrvg1 and LV1, what is the LV name and what is the volume group, where from onwards we are created the this logical volume, and here it will be showing the size and current LVs, everything will be showing. Okay, fully. Okay, now we have to create one more LVM. Okay, LV create, we can use same command here, our command is there, and we are using same volume group. Now we are going to creating LV2 with using the 5 GB, same. Okay, so LVS, now we are created the 2 LVS. Okay, using only single volume group. Okay, using only single volume group, but we are created as a 2 LVMs. Okay, now we have to format the LVM. Now we have to format the LVM. So as of now we are created the LVM. Now we are going to format the LVM. MK, using the format MKFS dot XFS, okay, /dev mapper. We have to use two ways names, LVM names always we have to use two ways. One is /dev VG1 volume group name and LVM name. One more is mapper, then VG and LV1. Okay, we have to use like this only. Yeah, it's done. And one more is there now, LV. Has done. Then we have to go for mount. So here mount is two type, one is temporary mount, one is permanent mount. So you guys knows about the temporary mount. I think temporary mount in the sense we have to create one disk, and the disk we have to create one part directory, and that folder, that directory we have to mount the this LVM. One server is restarted, one server is goes down, after reboot the server, the mount point will be disconnect. Okay, That's why we have to write the entries on fs tab. Okay, so we'll go for write the entries first. VIM first, we have to create the mkdir lv1. We have created the same lv1. Okay, we have to create one more lv2. We have two lvms na. So and VIM slash etc fs tab. Okay, here it will be showing as a first is UUID. UUID in the sense universal unique ID. Every disk, every partition name, it will be come with universal unique ID. In future, in real time, if you guys are going to mount the partition is a permanently, at that time you guys will have to use as a universal unique ID. Why? Because so now see our LVM partition naming, we are given the naming LV1 and LV2 and LV3. So if by mistake I was given has any bad entries on FS tab, one server will goes to down and suddenly server is went for down and it's coming up. So at the time booting the server will be struggle, the we can server can't boot properly. So that's why we have to use universal unique ID only. Now I'm going to using just disk name only, slash dev slash mapper slash vz1-lv1. This is my disk name, partition name, and I'm going to mounting this lv1. Okay, and I'm going using the XFS file system I was used and default here we have to use 00. Okay, many mistakes here, I think we'll see. We'll enter the command and save and exit, then mount -a. There is some bad entry size there, so we'll see the okay. This is a dev name is a different for, so we'll use for okay. We'll use oh, here some mistake has done. We're going to use that slash dev slash vz1 slash lv1 and we need to save mount here. There again is showing, so lv display here we have to choose this. Okay, lv vz1. Okay, vim slash etc fs tab. See, if you enter any bad entries, just we have to enter the mount -a command, then we'll get the confirmation. What is this? Okay, this is right. What is this? Block ID for this. Okay, we have to use this block ID. And okay, you guys know you got the block ID. Okay, this is my block ID and mount point using XFS file system. Here is some issue, I think. Fine, and here we are using the XFS file system, and now we are going to mount this using the universal unique ID only. Okay, and save and exit, just you have to enter the command mount -a. Okay, ignore entries and 14 file mount to 14 in the sense. Universal unique ID, it's fine only now. Okay, here is a mistake. Okay, yeah, it's done. So see, if your mistake any single word in the sense we can't mount the partition, LVM one is done, and we have to use one more is there na, blk id. Then slash dev vz1 and lv as done. We got the block id. Okay, fine. Again we have to go to mount the partition here. First we have to enter and we have to remove this one only, and after that we have to give the mount lv2 and xfs file system dfaults, then 0 and 0. Save and exist. Again we have to run mount -f. Done. So as of now we are created the two primary standard partition, so four primary partition, and thus to four partitions we are converted to PV. After that we have added those four partition to one LVM group. On that LVM group we are created the two LVs. So on the two LVs we are formatted using the XFS file system. Okay, and after that I was created two directories, and those two LVMs we are mounted to using two directories to permanently mount. If you restart the server, it won't unmount. Okay, so why? Because we are added an FS tab entries. See, and now we are going to extend the partition. So now it's mounted only, we are not unmounting any LVMs here. Now we'll going to be reduce the LVM. So we have to extend the LVM. So here we have to extend the LVM. We have to use as a two command, resize fs2, then you have to use lv extend also, lv extend then -l and plus, and we have to use plus then size. So plus we have to use 6 GB, and already 5 GB is there, again we are adding 6 GB. So first we have to, before that we have to check LV display, what is the free size of our LVM. So VG display, first we have to check the our VG size. There is a free size is 6 GB only, we can't extend the 6 GB. Okay, so LV extend -l and plus 2 then slash dev vg1. Okay, successfully we are extended. Just we have to check lv display, what is the size of now, it still is showing 5 GB only. That's why we have to use resize e2 what is the command there, resize 2fsck slash dev vz1 and lv1. Now we'll see. It's added lvm. No, it's not added. Bad magic number is super block while trying to. Okay, could not find valid file system super block. So e2 fsck